Did you know you could greatly improve your biking comfort and stability by switching out your seat post? In today's video, we are going to be talking about just that. But first, let's get to the bike shop. Let's do this. Thanks. Did you know you could easily change your biking comfort and stability by simply switching out your seat post? In today's video, we're gonna be looking at what a suspension or dropper seat post is and why you may want one for your electric bike, your cargo bike, or even your road and gravel bikes. Hey, I'm Arlie with Bike Shop Girl. On this channel, I'm focused on helping people bike more and worry less, with an emphasis on daily life by bike. If you are interested in finding the joy and freedom of two wheels for yourself or family, you have found your home and you should really hit subscribe. In this video, we are first going to be discussing what a suspension seat post is, and then a dropper seat post, and why you may or may not want one for your bike. Now, we're gonna be covering a lot in this video. I'm gonna try to keep it nice and condensed, but if you're looking for something specific, you can find timestamps below. A few years ago, when I first started riding electric bikes, one of the things that really surprised me was that you aren't naturally shifting your weight around or standing up out of the saddle because your electric assist takes care of a lot of the small inefficiencies you are making up for, like climbing out of the saddle or standing up and letting your legs be shock absorbers. You may experience the exact same thing on a laid-back hybrid or if you're new to cycling. So in the longer rides, I was finding my bottom side. I don't know if I'm allowed to say the alternative to bottom on YouTube. So I was finding my bottom and back were getting sore on longer rides on my cargo and electric bikes because I just was sitting the whole time. Enter the suspension seat post. Typically, these are either designed around an elastomer or a spring that provides some type of suspension between your saddle and the bike. My go-to suspension seat post right now are the Cane Creek Thudbuster ST, which stands for short travel, and then the Redshift seat post. Most of these suspension seat posts have some ability to tune the amount of give your seat post has specifically to your weight and your riding style. Personally, I just want my suspension seat post to take the edge off. Other people like to feel like they're floating in the seat post. I have a seat post in from Connect Cirrus. I'll link below. And that one makes me feel like I'm floating, which is really comfortable. But as someone that comes from road biking, it's really strange. So I would recommend to try different types of suspension seat post to see what is best for you. So another thing you'll notice with an electric bike and especially a loaded down cargo bike is that you don't necessarily want to lean your bike, especially if you have 200 pounds of cargo on that bike, at a stop sign or when you come to a stop. So you need to come off the saddle when stopped instead of tipping the bike to the side from the saddle like you might do on a road bike or mountain bike. Most people, when they first start riding bikes, even if they're just starting to ride a cargo bike, They want to stay in the saddle when they are stopped, so they don't have to worry about the balance of getting on and off one of those heavy bikes at a stop. With that in mind, we sometimes start with people's saddle a bit lower. This isn't ideal for their leg extension or their knees, but with an electric assist bike, I'm not as worried about it. Once they have the confidence in balance and handling on the bike, we start to slowly move the saddle back up to their optimal seat height position. Still, for some people, this isn't ideal. So to help with this issue, we use something called a dropper seat post. With a flick of a lever on your handlebars, you can drop your seat post a few inches down and be nice and comfortable on the saddle. And then when you're back up to speed and balanced, you unweight your seat by pushing that lever a little bit and your saddle goes back up into the ideal seat height position. Pretty clever, right? This technology came from mountain biking, where you want to drop your seat out of the way so you can get back and over your seat for downhills or technical riding. The other benefit of a dropper seat post on an everyday bike is it allows two people to easily share a bike without adjusting the seat height with the quick release or a tool every time they get on it. My wife and I are about 4 inches different in height, and I've been testing out the idea of a dropper seat post on bikes we share often, like the Turn HSD or our dedicated Urban Aero that is basically a minivan for our family. When I get on, I push the lever and the seat goes to the high position for me. And before she gets on, she pushes the lever and pushes down a little bit on the seat and it drops to the position she needs. But wait, there's more. PNW now has a seat post that does both suspension and dropper called the Coast. This is a suspension and dropper seat post in one package. I've been trying this on cargo and gravel bikes, and it works well. The dropper isn't as easy to engage as other dedicated dropper seat posts, and the suspension takes a bit more to dial in as it is using air pressure. I found that you have to be very precise with your air settings so the saddle doesn't sag too much under your weight, but also if you have too much air, it takes a bit more force for the dropper to release and the saddle to drop down. My prediction and hope is that we are going to see a lot more of these Goldilocks of suspension and dropper seat post in the future, which makes me really excited as they truly enhance your riding experience, especially for new riders or people using big bikes like electric and cargo bikes. All right, before the end of this video, I want to talk about some additional thoughts on dropper and suspension seat post. Number one, and maybe the most important thing to research before you get too excited about this idea, is to see if you have the necessary seat post height to use one of these. Depending on your setup, you're going to need 3 to 5 inches of seat post exposed where the suspension or dropper aspect of the post goes. Number two, the cost of these starts between $100 to $500 for the fanciest of dropper seat post. You can literally use an app to activate some of these seat posts. Pretty cool, maybe a little bit not necessary. Number three, there really aren't many places to test out various versions of this. I personally have them on a few bikes for test rides in my shop, but that doesn't mean your local shop does. So see if local friends have them, you know, order from a shop that maybe will allow you to test and send back. Try, taste, see what you like and what works best for you. Four, personally, I would add some type of pinhead or lock to these seat posts to keep them locked on. They are expensive and they catch people's eyes. If you're putting one of these on a bike like the Turn HSD or GSD, and you're wanting to use one of Turn's handlebar options for the back passenger, like the Joyride or the Sidekick bar, you may not be able to use the bar or the C-post in combination. The clamp on the Joyride or Sidekick bars are designed to be on the upper C-post of a turn bike. On a dropper post, I just can't use the Joyride or the Sidekick. And on a suspension C-post, I have to have enough room above the C-post clamp to clamp the Joyride or the Sidekick. Something to think about and to ensure that this works for you and your unique bike setup. Now that I got all of the notes out of the way, what do you think? Are one of these C-posts in your future? I would love to hear from you in the comments below. What do you think about this technology? Does suspension or dropper make sense for you? Let me know. Alrighty, until the next video, this was Arlie with Bike Shop Girl, where I'm helping you bike more and worry less.